I lived in a little street called Little Granville in Kilburn. I lived with my mum and dad and my eldest sister, who was 18 months older than me, Rose, me, Joan, Pam, 14 months younger than me, and Jean, she was 2 years old, and baby Kitty, 9 months old. I knew about the war because everybody was talking about it, and I used to play with the little boy next door. We used to sit and chat, and this little boy was full of the war. He said, oh, it's going to be a war. All the streets are going to be dark. We're not going to be able to see, and there's going to be bombs dropping. I didn't know what it meant, but I liked listening. Didn't know any more about the war till my dad said, we're all going on holiday. Mummy, you, and Auntie Doll. We were thrilled. We got on the train. I dropped the baby's bottle as we got on the train, which upset my mum. And my dad emptied the chocolate machine, put loads of pennies in, so we had all these bars of chocolate. And we were really happy. We chugged our way to Radlett. We all got out of Radlett and sat in a field. There was lots of other mothers there with children. We all sat in a field next to Radlett station, and they gave us, all the mums, a bag with, I remember, big bars of chocolate in it, very big bars, cream, custard cream biscuits, and I think it was dried egg and dried milk, all sorts of things to start them off. Took to a place, it was called the Masonic Hall in Radlett, just off Radlett village. And it was like a hospital because there was lots of other families there, and we all had a bed with a locker, just like a hospital ward. We were thrilled with our locker. We were all locking our lockers up, and oh, lovely. We had a piano. We were all crushing away on the piano. Then Rosie came back from Hayes. My dad brought Rosie down at the weekend. She'd come back from Hayes. So she went jumbling. My mum was very upset. She went round the house and come back with the baby's pram full of jumble. And we had great fun there. It was good fun with my mum, it really was. We all went to school in Radlett, Rosie, Pam and I. And my mum kept taking us to visit this lady. She took Rosie first. Then my mum kept taking Pam and I to visit a lady. And she kept saying, do you like this? Look at her lovely gold egg cups, Joan. I said, I don't like them. One day she took us to see the lady, and she ran out and shut the door and left us there. I screamed, kicked the door, kicked and kicked at the door. The lady hit me, and then she got a cane to hit me. And I went to bed sobbing. I didn't see my mum again after she left for, I think, about 5 years. Well, my mum was similar to me. She didn't laugh a lot. But she was ever so warm and kind and lovely. She never had much money, but she just made lovely things, lovely food, and she was just lovely. I adored her, absolutely adored her. Mm. Mrs. Weaver was always listening to the radio when we come in. She used to have her feet up on a little stool. I think her feet ached. She always looked very nice. She was a very neat, oldish lady, and she always was listening to the radio. And when she put us to bed, Vera Lynn used to sing on the radio, "Good night, children everywhere." It's making me cry now. To all the little evacuees, and I used to cry. Pammy used to say, "Oh, be quiet." And I used to be crying. I want mummy, Pam. Do you? I want mummy. And that was every single evening. When we was at home, we had to string the onions or clean the silver cutlery for hours and do horrible jobs, polish the floors, they were wooden. I used to lay under the bed and have a little rest with the polished rag. And she had a little nap on a Sunday afternoon. So we were supposed to be out in the garden, the field at the top of the garden. She used to have a little nap Sunday afternoon. It was so hot. Pam and I used to creep up. She used to leave the kitchen window open so we got a drink, but I think she found out. So then she started locking the kitchen window. So we used to go out of the little field at the top of the garden to the big field next door and have a drink out of the cow's thing. Pam used to push all the flies away and I used to have a drink, and she used to have a drink, and we'd have a little game up there, which was quite fun. She used to take us to her friends every Saturday round the corner to have a bath in her bathroom, because she didn't have a bathroom, and the woman had a lovely bathroom. One day I was just getting in the bath undressed, and the lady walked in, and the lady said, "Oh my God, what's that on her body?" So my lady said, her name was Mrs. Weaver, my lady. Mrs. Weaver said, tell her what that is on your body. And I told her that I'd done naughty. And the woman was horrified. And the next thing I knew, a lady came and said, "I'm taking you to live somewhere else." She said, "You're going home today. You're going home tomorrow to London to your mum." I couldn't believe it. I didn't think I was ever going home. "To London," she suggests, "to your mother in London." The next day, a car came for us. And we got in the car, and I said goodbye, and I hurry up. I wanted the driver just to shut the doors and go. And I couldn't believe it. And we drove off, and they put us on a train with lots of other children. And we sat there, and I was a bit upset because we went to Euston. I think it was Euston King's Cross. Well, I knew we should be in Cricklewood, because Cricklewood was near where I lived. So I was still a bit upset, but when we got off the train, there was a big, big party in Euston Station. Lots of kind women all talking to us, sweets and cakes and jellies, everything. But I couldn't eat, I felt too sick. I just wanted to get to Cricklewood. And all of a sudden, my mum walked in. And once I saw my mum, I was so happy. And I took a bag of sweets, ran to my mum, and we all came home in ambulances.